Good morning, Brian Harris here, Information Officer for the Great Basin Team 2, for a morning update for Monday, October 12th for the northeast zone of the fire. So some numbers first. Overall, the entire August complex is at 1,028,801 acres and at 75% contained. Now in the northeast zone, we're at 270,036 acres and 55% contained. Overall, throughout the entire complex, we have 4,610 firefighters and support personnel working the fire. So this is our morning update, and I'll bring in Britt Davis. He's our Deputy Operations Section Chief for an update of what's going on the northeast zone. Britt.
Okay, good morning. I'm going to start up here on the very west side of our piece of line. Up here in the Bear Wallow area, we continue to prep this ridge down for a potential burnout, but over the last couple days, you know, we got quite a bit of rain and we've been noticing IR is not moving. This fire is not really moving down in that drainage. It's too steep for us to get in there and attack it directly, but I think we're gonna spend quite a bit of effort working this with helicopters over the next day or two and see if we can't potentially hang it up down in there without actually having to commit up to a firing operation along the ridge. We are going to continue to prep for that burnout in case we get our hand forced, but right now we're feeling pretty confident like we can hang fire up in its current footprint. Continuing south, they're continuing to prep for this. We will probably eventually fire this one out. It's a small piece that just is easier to hold when we bring it all together than the several lines that are in there now. Continuing on south of Progeny, we are mostly just in a holding and mop-up mode all the way down to the Begum Thumb, we're calling it. We do have a little bit more containment line that we added yesterday. We anticipate that's going to continue to expand out from there over the coming days. They're having a lot of good progress. We've got the Marines fully embedded with us and just got a lot of horsepower out there mopping and securing up. They did complete getting line all the way around the Begum Thumb yesterday. So they'll be mopping that up and continuing to secure that. There's still some heat in there, but we're feeling pretty confident that we're in a good place there. Today we've got a new Division Oscar that is really, their job is tying us down into the buck fire and getting that piece finished up. So expect, you know, we've got three hot shot crews down there managing that, and they're going to be coming up with a plan and getting engaged with that today. Then continuing over to the east side of our fire, there is still isolated, I don't even want to say pockets, but hot spots that were identified by infrared yesterday. So they're going to be out taking care of that, continuing to patrol, and then really just doing backhaul. There's all kinds of equipment and hose and supply out there that they're going to be cashing up and bringing back in. And I think that's it.
Hey, Britt, it's always a great thing that we can, when we add containment lines, so this black line here, gosh, you know, runs about 6 miles or so. But once again, what does it mean when we actually put containment black line on our map?
Well, really what this means is we are really highly confident that fire is not going to progress beyond that point. So it doesn't mean it's cold out. We've got plenty of black line down here, and there's still, you know, they still pick up little pockets of heat that we didn't pick up the first time through. And so possibly that's still there, but we'll be monitoring it over the next couple days. And as that progresses, we'll continue to build confidence in it. But when you see a black line on a map, that's a really good thing from our perspective.
That's great. So thanks for that update. You know, just for a reference point, where we put that containment line right here, this is Highway 36 that comes in and Highway 3 dropping down. Post Mountain area right here, so that containment line is right there. So that's it for our update for this morning. If you do need additional information, always visit our INSA website. When you get to our INSA website, up in the right-hand side, there are phone numbers there. And phone numbers for not just this zone, but for the west zone and for the south zone as well. Now, I do want to kind of give a little bit of a heads up. We're the Great Basin Team 2, and the Great Basin Team 1 is taking over the northwest side of this fire. So it might be a little bit of confusion, but we do have two Great Basin Type 1 teams that will both be on the northeast and the northwest side of the fire. So we'll refer to things as zones, us again being the northeast zone and our other Great Basin team being on the northwest zone. So that'll be it for our update this morning. Thank you and have a great day.